See, that's what we need over at Marshall. It's always a parent volunteers, okay, I know, probably what, 5 or 6 days.
He did some of the, he went to some of the class, Dover did a couple classes, and so they act, they pay him like $40, $45, somewhere in that ballpark, a game. Yeah, so he's excited.
Oh my god, he makes more than Scott, Scott's cash.
Great.
So, Ethan, Bill will go just to like supervise, because you just never know. Well, Ethan was supposed to pick him, and couldn't, he ended up picking hours up, somebody called and said, so he went into work instead for my dad. So, I guess, do you remember the names? God, I'm drawing a blank now. They're brothers, and honestly, they were in the Dover.
I'll have to say no, but.
Give me a second. I'll think of their names. I can't remember how, Joe and, oh my god, it's gonna drive me insane. It's a brother duo, and the Dover board actually asked them no longer to coach, because it got so bad, they got in the aunt's face, and was just yelling.
Oh,
it was really bad.
Wow.
He goes, could you imagine? No, I can't. I could never. It's bothering me that I can't even think of their names.
Yeah, so summer tours usually have a team, but only 7 girls came out this year for 8 years. I know. And I couldn't convince 3 other girls. I'm like, please.
For all of them.
So, in the 8U division, I have Summersworth, Rawlsford, Berwick. All of the Berwicks are allowed to play with us. Rawlsford and Summersworth. And Lebanon, if you want. Like, they reached as far as.
And you gotta eat girls.
And there's only 16 girls in the 8U division total. And only 7 came out for tryouts. So, I wanted them to play somewhere. So, we normally go to Dover. Dover didn't have any summer teams at all. 8, 10, or 12 years. Like, what? Dover? So we called Rochester, and Rochester does, so we had to get away from the state. Our girls straight out, only 3 made it, Zoe and 2 others. And I'm like, oh great, Rochester has great reputation. This coach is killing their reputation. I've never seen a coach at Rochester like it in my life. In my life. I've been doing it for what, 12 years?
How old's Kate? Kate's older than mine.
Yeah.
She's graduated from high school. 17?
Yeah. So I was like, okay, great. You know, I won't have to coach this year. I'll be able to sit on the sidelines. I can't sit on the sidelines. I pace because I could stand with parents because I was ready to like kill them. Oh my god. And then I was so happy he put her on the bench. He subbed her. I'm like, great. She won't be the one getting screamed at. And he's
insane.
He's screaming at his own daughter.
You shut her up.
8-1.
You shut her up.
Is Catwoman going?
Yes, she went to go measure shed doors.
Okay, I know that.
So yes, we'll have a quorum. I think we have a quorum without Kevin.
It's okay. It's a workshop.
Anybody know about last time?
No. So we knew this last time.
Yes.
Which is less than what's been reported to me.
Yes.
So should I go off this or go?
Did they end up hiring Jerry?
Yes.
They did. Bill goes on vouch for him in the summer. He's
this is missing $20.
Yeah. So how much are you off?
That would be enough, $40.
I just updated the numbers.
I'm showing 262.
Yeah, it
was just me. That includes.
I tried to
say it was like one answer.
I could tell he was nervous.
He is very nervous. My husband's coach. him, has voted for years and talking.
I got teams that were reporting.
He's very quiet, one word answers, he goes, well, he's very shy to begin with, so once he warms up to an adult, he'll be fine. But he loved, he will be really good with kids, he really will. He just gets the bad rap for his older siblings.
Yeah.
But he feels like, I guess I'll vouch for Kelly needs to be.
I can do a line adjustment to make it match that.
I just ran the numbers at home.
Brittany, I saw your email about the trade room.
That's not in the, they're saying $550.
For t-shirts only.
Always supposed to be Thursday.
For bracelets.
Originally going to be Thursday.
This is in my.
And then.
What is that report?
I think you moved it.
This is one of these. This is one says from the last,
like, three series trades.
So, no, this is your.
Okay, so, all right, so when is the CPR?
You won't get paid in the.
I don't know, because I reported to me, it was a mess. So, I don't know, if I have some left going, okay, I have.
One of the girls.
So.
Should be a problem.
And I guess that's one thing that we can talk about tonight.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Because I have very few numbers reported to me.
I mean, what do you think?
So this one is.
Rather than, I mean, we definitely, Sarah's all set with using this, but.
I think.
Which is wrong, better showing.
I think it might be better, because Andy.
Yes, because I know.
So Kate said either night is fine.
Yeah.
Because I know.
Okay.
$20. I think.
I think it makes a lot more sense.
I think you told everybody.
So that would bring us to 443.
Is that so okay?
And you see.
Oh, yeah.
Another $5.
So.
Because I didn't see that on the. Your sister-in-law.
So do you still want to have it here on Thursday? And
yeah.
And ship to the school on Friday?
I bought two extra shirts. Well, three.
Sarah thinks it's going to be Thursday. I'll just say, we just need Thursday.
Okay.
Two gray ones and two blue ones.
Thank you.
Yeah,
you can look this over.
Two gray.
Well, the gray ones for.
Oh, the town, and then the actual camper shape.
Okay.
If that makes sense to us.
And how much are we charging for a shirt?
Yes.
$12 each or two for 20.
So I'm going to wash my hair.
That would be $10 each.
Thank goodness we brought her.
I can tell you right off the top, this is $20.
And this was 52.
Are we actually going?
No, we're waiting for those.
Okay.
I said you were in.
Application for Alex.
We hired this.
Okay.
She's got his.
It's not it. Figured
you it. I just dropped it off the top.
$20.
That sounds
good. Yeah.
That one was the missing $20.
That one was I'm going to hand these over.
What is that?
Are those keys?
These passes. Are the bus passes
okay.
For all the state parks. Okay.
Yep.
They're officially out of my possession.
So you should wait till we record. Do that.
No.
Do you want it back?
That's just official. I'm ready to hand.
Yeah, you pretty much should. Hand it over. Give me all
of yours.
No, seriously.
Do we have to wait to talk about the shit?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Should we open this meeting here?
You go right ahead.
That's
At least the first page, then.
Right. 741. 741.
Meeting has been open.
yes, this, I just wanted you to hold up on the shed right now, just so we figure out money with the drain at the town hall. So
he was going to start the middle of next week anyways and do the roof. So just when you get the go, you let me know.
Do we have, how much does he need? I know you sent over like six things of shingles. What does it need?
I kept forwarding your emails to him.
I'll call him.
Thanks.
Well, Kathy said she had something about wood.
Kathy,
did you see that?
Kathy and I just met. She was going home on the. To look at the doors, she has material for the doors and would like to come to us this weekend. And her husband's going to be doing. I don't know what material she was thinking about, but she was, she
excellent that it would be no cost for staff to have to.
So please talk to her.
Awesome.
I say go, I will send her an email, or you can send her an email.
As long as it doesn't cost the county any money right now, that would be great.
So as of now, we'll get the doors and the roof fixed and whatever else we need to patch up, we can do that.
Yeah, the shingles, I think the shingles isn't that much. We have two at the town hall and we need four more. Is that what he said? He said we needed six bundles. So.
Let's see what we're going to ask him.
So do, what is the numbers now?
I don't have the numbers, that's what he has, so.
I put together an agenda,
I have all of these new registrations, so.
All of us came from Boston.
I don't know if those need, well, since probably not the last time I saw you, there was one new one today.
But I was gonna,
Are you entering them? Do you have?
I told Dee I would update numbers.
Okay.
For tonight's meeting. So.
This is one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12 kids.
So last time we had 62. And with the, this is the one for today.
Yep.
So he's in third grade.
Yeah.
Is that from the Facebook thing I sent this morning? That's a good question.
Facebook thing.
Oh, you can't name drop.
I know.
There was an email that I made to register on the Facebook as of this morning.
I can tell you
what. Somebody dropped that off at the town hall today. So I don't know if that was that
can
in
I see the
person.
It was
an out of town person.
That's
this is the kid, and that's the mom.
Nope. Okay. So.
Okay. Elsie talked to the folks about it, and she might be sending through this.
This one. This is Elsie.
Oh, yes, I knew that name.
I was waiting for numbers.
Oh. But can we, if we're up to 72, do we have enough counselors for 73?
74?
Well, we have 9 counselors plus 2 management, right?
Right.
One of them is part-time now, right?
Yes. And this is part-time.
Okay, so we have 12.
Jay is too, right? I use First Financial. It's part time.
Did you ever confirm that?
And you did the calling and he did the test.
Okay.
I know he said in our group that Al said yes. I don't know what he said about Jared.
Okay.
Sorry.
It was a new customer Alex.
Yeah.
So we have 8 plus a part timer confirmed?
Alex Lance.
L A G O.
There's 9 official.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
8 plus 5.
You're good.
All right.
I was like, no. Yeah,
9 full time.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 full time, 1 part time.
Okay.
And your niece did not.
She still hasn't yet. I saw her again last night and I was like, are you sending in? And she said yes. So we're hoping that she is a sub for us. Yes, yeah, so she's not interested in.
Okay. Yeah, nothing made it to our table.
Yeah, I know. So
well, right now we're at.
I don't know what she's waiting for.
6.5 to 1.
You can't count Andrew.
Okay.
Why not?
Because
he's the warrior.
We want to try to keep him out of the numbers.
Okay, so we're at 7.2 to 1. We want to be at 8 to 1, right?
Yeah.
Does that include taking out the part-timer?
That doesn't include any part-timers.
Oh, perfect. Yeah.
So now if you have someone that's sick, that brings us to 8 to 1.
So are you guys okay with me responding yes to this Do we have room for one more?
I would say so, because right now we're 7.2 without the part-timer.
Okay. Oh, I have new service.
I don't either.
So with the applications that I just looked at, we're up to 74 calipers.
Oh, now we're at 74. Okay.
Would you do the math right there?
72. That's what. All right. So
we have
72 plus this person that emails, that would be 75?
That would be 75. And I will give you the breakdown right now.
75 divided by 8. So with that other camper, we'll put this at 8.33.
Without the part-timer.
Without the part-timer, and that's with no kids being sick. Us getting 100% attendance. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, 100% attendance.
For campers, I'm talking about.
Yeah, you're not going to get 100%.
Yeah.
No.
Maybe Monday.
I know. Yeah, maybe. Monday. I know two will be gone for a couple of weeks. I don't know. Mine will be gone for a whole week.
Yeah.
So, 74 campers. Breakdown right now is 34 first through third graders. 21 fourth and fifth, and 19 sixth through eighth. Now this is where we run into a problem, because at the last meeting we said we were fine with 17 pre-care, but we were capping it there. We've had two more registrations come in for pre-care.
That's fine, because you can take.
There was two that dropped out.
Okay, that's fine. So two dropped out, so we're still at 17 total?
Yes.
Okay.
And you have the same two dropped out of post-care.
So two dropped out of post-care, and we had two sign up for post-care, so we're still at 9. Okay. So if that's fine with you guys.
Yeah.
I was just a little concerned because I had seen some more pre-care come in. But we might
that one today, I believe. He's looking for pre and post. So is that?
Yeah, he was the first one I did.
Okay.
And when I put out the flyer, I only said post care. I didn't put pre care on there. Mm-hmm.
Do you have a list of? You don't have a. You couldn't have a list of all the kids.
No, I do. Never got back to me.
Okay.
I have a list of the ones that are all getting t-shirts.
That should be every camper, because they're all getting t-shirts, right?
I'm
getting t-shirts. Well, if you're your name is on the list twice, I trust her to do that.
Is it in the spreadsheet?
I'm sorry, you catch that?
I just don't have the one that came in today.
So add it in that space.
Sure.
Oh,
I should be sitting next to you
straight
up. I might be the one.
The next one was right there.
Britain. We will be their runners.
Okay. So.
That's not good, but
no. Sorry, no.
Maybe we'll get in with the future next year.
Okay, so
we think they have a talent card.
Can you review?
They're not in the
town. We have 9 staff now.
We have with Brittany. So Andy, Brittany, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They are 5 over the age of 18, full time. That includes our director and assistant director. So 3 full-time over the age of 18, 1, 2, 3, 4 full-time under the age of 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 9 full-time people.
Including Andy.
Including Andy, yes.
So a minute ago it was 9 without Andy.
Yes. So we have 1 part-time?
Not with a part-time, no.
Yeah. Thank you.
I was wondering where your math was coming from.
That was at 9.3.
9.3.
So shaking, you're on your knees.
Yes, it's 9 with Andy. But Janessa, who is our part-time, who will be there Monday, puts us at 10 for Monday.
Which would be a 1 to 7.4 ratio, if you're including Andy.
Okay, so we have a backlog of minutes that go back to April. They were all included in the email I sent. Wondering if anybody had read any of them, or if we're just going to table them.
We're going to table them.
But before we move on, we were talking about campers and employees and so forth. Are we full now?
Well, if we're at 9.3.
We decided at our last meeting, Esther, to asking if they could register on the first day of camp. And we said no, they had to register by this Thursday. And that would be the cutoff date. Absolutely no more after Thursday. And all your funds and everything had to be in. And then we would be able to go on Monday. And if you weren't registered by Thursday, everything paid in full, you would be turned away from Monday.
So we put that out there too. 20 seconds after you're up there.
So how many people do we have that are paid?
Paid staff?
No, staff.
He wants to know how many still owe whatever balance. Do we even know that?
According to my record, we have 3 that are paid. That's why I'm asking.
Oh, I do.
Yeah, she says she's 3 of them, so that doesn't do my math. And that's one of my complaints.
These are all the registrations reported by the town as of last week.
Does it have names next to it?
No,
parents?
It has just has numbers, like receipts.
So a 964 represents 3 kids?
Well, that's the problem we're running into is, like, Caroline's putting in how much everybody paid, and we don't know if that's pre-care, post-care, or how many kids it breaks out here.
What do you need? I'm sorry, what do you need? Because this is my list. This is my handwritten list.
Of who we still owes money?
Yes.
That's what we're discussing. Lester wants, he only has 3 people paid in full.
So I'm thinking we might have to piece with a bunch of the counselors on Monday.
You only have 3 paid in full?
But I have some frustrations around the reporting. we're trying to work out some of the frustrations on the shirts because I'm showing different numbers and you know, as I get the emails, I just put them in.
Yeah.
We're supposed to, when we go to town and give them a check, we send me an email. Yeah. But I've gotten like 3 emails, and there's obviously been more trips to town. So, I mean, I can just write down this and how much money we have, but I have no idea if this is pre or post or, you know, what.
Okay, so let me tell you what I've been doing. So I have been visiting town hall weekly. So this is what I do. So I get the check right open, right? And on the front page of every kid's registration is this. So this is what I'm filling out. And then I will write in the corner, so this is what I've been writing. And that's why I have my master sheet. So this is missing $7 for their second shirt. So And a copy of this goes into a folder in the town hall, Caroline. So this is all the stuff on there. All registration plus $7 for an extra shirt. So this would be
so you can turn away this and this $7. Okay, I just want to make sure I understand.
So they paid the deposit.
Oh, my God.
I'm also, but if they show up with their registration fee that day?
Only this person paid.
Like the whole, like $265.
Okay, now I'm like, how, because if we don't send it to say.
And how are you going to know when they paid the $265?
Because for everyone, the money that comes back in, I have another receipt.
So, but how, like.
I get, this is a copy of. I have a copy of this in a folder with a handwritten receipt that corresponds with this number. I staple it to that and it goes in a folder that says paid in full. So I went through that today and I came up with this.
Black and white.
And that's the only thing that people are owing.
Right, and it really should be like bolded saying, it's this plus this for your total cost of this.
So I only have.
So next year we should get.
I only have nine.
I just.
So I brought my husband's phone dollars. And so this is paper. My list.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was like, I was still saying.
And I need to.
And I will be less.
Yes.
I did it in the record check.
Yeah, I was like, oh, yeah, yeah.
Registration. And I think so. I don't know. I didn't know your kids' names, it just came out.
Like, I'm looking at you.
I just changed to Emmett Never.
I will get another number here, I will check number on there. So I'm putting those together. So it sounds to me that we need to look at.
What did I read somewhere?
She's the assistant, let her speak, it's her job.
I don't know. That's one thing that we didn't cover.
I didn't know if I had to go there or realize that. I know a lot of state courts talk about that, but.
So this is what I, so. As far as I know, everybody else is paid in full. Except for these people and I am all what they're doing. And this is you, this is me. This is you.
So.
So I have to go down to town hall.
Well, half of us are sleeping there.
And go through her records.
So we're covered on both areas.
That would probably be a piece.
I don't know.
So I think the first one would be terrible to go with both of them. But I don't, wasn't that, I have next one, whatever, but everyone didn't want.
We talked again, we talked about, first we'll talk about.
Right, and that's the one.
Kelly said they don't have lifeguards, they want a lifeguard.
So, I mean, I can just go down there and ask her as far as you know.
It's unfortunate that she didn't put a name on those.
She just, you said.
This just, that might be a check number, so these are the memos, so this is, so all of those will correspond with, this is the.
So all of them, but I think.
So I'm assuming this is a check number.
So we have like one more that got away the other day in Kingston, because we found.
So this is all the money that we.
There's no guarantee.
Shirts.
No.
Everything.
Especially on a Tuesday.
Can.
I don't know.
So I want to recap
what's going on.
Yeah, two or three conversations going on.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm over here. And then she, there's a separate.
So this is just registration then?
Yes.
Registration, what do we call it?
Call it pre and post care.
Pre and post care and camp dues.
Yes.
And some camp shirts, that's the problem, some camp shirts are mixed in.
Are they on that one, are you sure?
If they, paid with their registration, it went in there.
So like on this one, so let me just give you an example. These two kids, right? These two kids, they had to pay a $7 fee for a second shirt. They actually did not pay their registration for the $7, so they only checked for $2. When they hand in the $2, then I need to get a receipt.
So what are we doing with this kid when he or she shows up Monday, and says, I'm here, and we say, well, you still owe us $35, you know, they partially.
Well, an adult's going to sign her in, correct? Or he or her.
And I may be there.
Okay, so.
Jody Boss is going to be there.
I will be.
What are you guys going to do then?
Well, I can tell you right now that I have made several phone calls and several emails to the people who still owe money. So this needs to be finished, of phone calls.
And I want to check your list against my list of checks. But I went through that list last week and noticed all the ones that end in two. Probably with the registration and the t-shirts.
Yes. Send you an email. Yes.
So like 42 is their registration and a shirt.
Yes, plus one shirt.
So that might make it easier. You're looking at an amount of $35. Yes. Or 42 is $35 plus a shirt.
Okay.
Or any weird number, you know, like this one is 507. So that means they're paying a certain amount plus I owed something.
And like one was 647 and one was
Was this as of today?
No, that was of debit cards
Thursday.
So it's changed
then. It was times count.
And is this as of today?
That's as of today.
Details.
Let me.
And is this yours or is this?
This is mine.
Cyber zone where we can.
That's my personal accounting on what is coming and what's not.
I saw the text afterwards, so I know.
And your personal accounting when you add this up is 485?
sign in, sign out for the day. They're going to start with $200 on Monday. And for whatever.
Is it for the week? That's the one.
We're going to have to make change on Monday, most likely someone's going to need it to start with. And then when you build that $200 back up in whatever it is, whatever, you're going to give that money back to the town, and then you're going to keep that in your box. But there is going to be a daily checkoff. Yes, at the beginning of the day, two people are going to sign in.
This is what was in the box.
$200 in the box. There's $240 at the end of the day. There's going to be a daily tally. So.
Okay, so at the, I can give you or whomever my email. So just at the end of the day, send me an email.
Do you want a daily total?
Well, that's what they're doing, so they might as well.
Okay.
There should definitely be somebody that counts it, signs it, and then a person that double checks it. And then it's the same thing. If you went into work, you have a startup cash. You count it when you first come in. This is what you started with. And at the end of the day, you have somebody that counts it and then recounts it. So basically, you're double checking it. No one's.
And you have a cash box for a lot of.
Yeah.
Not saying
I have
it.
A lot of things like I wanted someday.
Well, more importantly, money's sticking together, or, you know, I think that would happen more.
But I think it should be like a startup cash, and there should be an envelope. So you own, every day you start with $200 is that way. Because you. And there should be an envelope for like a deposit.
Yeah, there won't be a. The first
probably
week I could go
is start up at $200 a day.
The only reason why I picked $200 is because you're going to have a lot of people paying that week. So, I only have $20. We're actually going to make a lot of changes the first day.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. After that, probably $100 or whatever. But yeah, so.
But you want that information.
Well, so first week, they're going to start with $200. At the end of the week, they're going to return $200 to the town?
Once they make the $200 back,
okay.
They'll return that $200 back to the town.
Gotcha.
Because that's town fund. That's
right.
Your town starter fund.
And then moving forward, how?
And then you're just going to keep the cash box. And then we just have to decide at what point do you want them to turn it in. Like in the softball league, we only keep $80 in the cash box at every given hour. Anything more than that, get put in an envelope, then it's not brought off. Yeah.
I mean, assuming you don't have thousands of dollars sitting in there on Wednesday, which I
doubt.
Yeah, just say, look, we got too much money. But you gotta send me an email, let me know.
Right.
Otherwise, now, but the other question is, aren't they then going to replenish their water, popsicles, pizza, and whatever from that money?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Let's make sure Jody hears that question.
Sorry.
They're going to be replenishing their product
supplies
with that money as well.
Right.
Okay.
So they're going to keep the receipts and they're going to say, I took $50 out, we went to the Home Depot. We went to Home Depot for a field trip. No, you know, we bought popsicles or
whatever.
So just
shoot me a note on whatever you bring in and whatever you spend.
Yeah, right.
And
then you'll have receipts for the checks and balances.
Yeah. And so at the longest we'll go is 5 days, Friday.
Yep.
And
before that I'll shoot you.
Yep.
Okay. So, I'm just trying to figure out where I am. We talked about that. So we talked about the cash box and that it's going to have incoming funds and it's going to be checked off twice a day, once by somebody in the morning and once by somebody in the afternoon, hopefully double checked by a second person.
Mm-hmm.
And that they're going to use that money once they have some to buy whatever needed supplies. And you mentioned something to Kelly about a breakdown of communication about
hiring, right?
Yes, we just don't know, I don't know if Andy was actually called Jared yet. The text was completed. I texted him and he should get back to us.
So you're looking into that?
Yes.
So I put down question about hiring one staff person and who is making the employment offer, Brittany and Andy will be approved. Okay, so.
Everybody's notified that they're hired, they're ready to go for training.
That's the next thing on the list is training.
Yep.
So which 2 days are actually the days of training?
So it is Thursday and Friday.
Okay.
Thursday will be here, Friday will be at the school. And CPR is 8:30 to 10:30 Friday morning.
Here?
At the school.
At the school, well, everything at the school on Friday.
Everything's at the school on Friday.
So there's, so staff is doing.
Yeah, so they're doing the training with us in the morning, we're piggybacking the teachers CPR first aid.
Is it really officially out of school by then?
So the kids won't be there.
Yeah, Thursday's our last day.
Counselor stuff, like, is that there as a high school?
Yes, except for Alex, who has a final until 10:30 on Friday. So he won't be there, so that is gonna be one of our questions.
So he'll miss the CPR first aid?
Right, so having you there on Tuesday would be awesome until we find him something. I don't know how to go about that.
That's fine.
That's okay, yeah. As long as we find.
If 99% of the staff has first aid training and CPR, I can look that first week.
Okay.
That is a great accomplishment.
But my aunt took more than that.
Yes, right.
Aim high, so.
So then it's 4 to 8 at Friday evening, so it's coming.
At the school, it probably won't go until 8, but we walk.
That is my biggest hiccup for the week, we're gonna have a great week.
Yes. That's it, that's the only one.
So, I have a question for you on training.
Yes.
When your email came out, it said half first aid, half CPR. So, is that time-wise or half the staff doing first aid and half is doing CPR?
Right, so we have counselors trained in both areas rather than everybody just for CPR and no first aid.
So how are you breaking that down?
Okay, so we have, Izzy's already trained in both, so she's not coming on Friday morning. So we have Jordan, myself, Brighton, and Alex doing CPR. And then, oh, but Alex is here. Okay, so I have to change that.
So you have Jordan, Brighton, you, and.
Maybe one of the older kids?
At least one more, yeah, so.
Luke?
Yeah.
Luke, that's the last, I agree. It's all sets of people.
Did he respond to the emails? There seemed to be a.
I forwarded to him, and he's been getting responses, but I haven't been getting them, so I don't know who he's responded to.
Did your daughter get an email?
According to her, she got it and responded.
Okay.
So.
Because I asked Luke the other day, because we were all together, and he said, no, I ain't getting it. So.
I can try something.
I'm just wondering if it's better just to grab their phone numbers.
And left a voicemail for Jared.
Okay.
And it makes sense if you have 18 plus kids going to CPR and 16.
Yeah, that was the general idea.
Yeah.
Oh,
who?
18.
Yes.
Can you guys leave?
No. Can you see me?
Yes. So, do you want to know who's doing first aid?
Not necessarily. As long as I picked up on that suggestion of 18 plus new CPR, which I was thinking too, and if we're going with that, that's fine with me.
Okay, that's the general list. Yep. Okay.
So what is Janessa? Is Janessa coming on Friday?
Yes.
Yes.
She's doing CPR. That's the other one. There it is.
You meant that by that.
I did. Very good.
Okay. Registrations we already talked about, right?
I have a slew of people who owe for that, but.
So do I.
Anybody want to make a phone call?
Maybe.
I'll talk for you. You want to make a phone call?
Yeah.
Harassment phone.
So the answer to my question, though, that I proposed was, so you have people that have paid, say, 200 and some odd, but they haven't paid the 35 or the $7. They show up on the first day.
What are we doing?
If I'm at, I got a statement. I'm gonna be a little bit bold, here, you still owe this.
Should we print out something that says this is due tomorrow?
Well, you, when you're sitting up there, you'd be like, oh, who's your, okay, you still owe. Whoever they choose to be checking in people that day, I'll be sitting right next to them. So it's not on their shoulder, it'll be on my shoulder.
But so we will let that camper go to camp that day.
As long as there's a registration form. And like the bulk of their stuff is made.
The parents need signatures on stuff, of course. For safety reasons. But, yeah, if they've already paid part of whatever and we're still looking for.
And we don't care what part that is, if they paid $35, they still owe $265?
Yep.
Okay.
You're here today, if you don't bring it tomorrow, don't come.
And by the way, we're keeping the $235 or the $65 or whatever.
Yep.
Got it.
Yep.
That's fine.
It states non-refundable, that's in it on the front page.
We can write it on there real quick.
I have a feeling the reason why you're $35 short on a lot of them is because our paper doesn't state the amount plus $35.
Yes.
Because I was like, no, you don't owe it, and then I'll shut off text me like, no, it's not.
Yeah.
Yes, a glitch to be fixed for next year.
Which one do you want to see?
This one? Just the first one, it'll look odd.
And as of tonight, I will check with Kelly at the end of the meeting, but as of tonight, there are only 9 families that have to pay for shirts. Out of all of the people that are paying for shirts, I only have a list of 9, but I don't know if they've paid for t-shirts.
You have 9?
Yes.
Talking about the community shirts or the?
The camper shirts.
1, 2, 3.
Okay.
So the first you get a little piece of fish, we'll figure something else out.
Yeah.
Okay.
so that's okay though.
If she wants it, she can bring it to town bar.
Ooh.
Tomorrow, there's a lot to do.
So I'm gonna have you guys rewind, tell me what you're talking about.
Making a box?
Box.
Andy has this box swim idea for when there's no lifeguards. So the counselors would make the box in the water and then the kids make lots of bucks.
Come on.
I don't understand the box, but.
Well, you have two people out in the corner the farthest, and two people close.
Oh, okay.
No one goes out this way, no one, you know.
Yeah.
But the only issue is, so you have four counselors in the water.
Right. Sure, maybe six depending on.
But now we have two counselors that have stayed back.
Plus Andy and I, so that would be four.
No, like two that have stayed back at the school?
Yeah, two that have stayed back at the school, two stay behind. Because we want a male and female for a stay behind.
Right.
So that.
And then you have, what about the kids who are on the playground, maybe 11, I don't know.
Make box on them too.
Stay in this rectangle.
We now have a rectangle, a long rectangle. You know, and the thing was, they would go to these lakes in the past, and they just were like, don't get nobody around.
Yes, we just took care of it.
I think that, I don't know if you need.
This one, I tend to want types of people that can see.
The girls want to go to the courtesy reminder.
Well, that's something.
Did she laugh?
Oh, the boys want to bathroom, the girls want to bathroom, that's two counselors.
And then something on the playground.
And that's a third counselor. So that's seven counselors.
He also got that idea from Rochester where they had 200 kids and like a plethora of counselors.
Maybe we'll do the triangle thing.
I'm swear. Anything.
Everything's fully done, so if you get a section, you just like go here to the edge where.
Well, I mean, honestly, if you have two in the far two corners and one actually in the middle of the kids.
Oh, I bet you don't see.
I like.
Can we do that in the box?
Given the fact that you're saying, they're probably are
this woman, I already called her.
Not all the time.
You should just go ahead and look. We had discussed.
I
should bag it the first week, just because it's the first week. But if every single one of these is, you may not have what it says, we should go.
This isn't the bad inside, I just called them, but I'm going to raise it. It's like a very
shallow. Yes.
Those are just the families.
This goes forever.
It's shallow, yeah.
Yeah, shallow.
It's shallow.
Oh, for Jody.
Then again,
Jody, you know. Jody, I do the same thing.
That's true. If you have shallow.
So it went for a little while.
Can we write that down?
Yeah.
But it's very open, like White Lake especially, it's like the shore, it's just very, you know those nooks and crannies, it's very open.
Okay.
It's very gradual.
Okay, yeah.
So, it's not all of a sudden drop.
So, I said,
this was this one, right?
Yeah.
Jody, that one, right?
Remember that we went there the swingers.
Okay.
I think I'm getting
that too. Some big swingers.
So,
okay.
To get back on town.
Yeah, let's get back.
Alright,
since I would like to go inside of the box swim thing, and I called the Tuckaway again today, and they have zero lifeguards hired.
We've been talking about this, and
Roxanne
maintains that as far as she can tell, State Parks generally fills kind of lifeguards.
How do they do in the summertime,
though?
Really? Huh.
But they could have one on Monday, but not on Thursday, but I just like
I just know they're not always there when I've gone. When I saw the crowd last year, I was like,
huh.
Are they in the process of hiring? Do you have them been hiring?
Yes. That's what they told me. So I said, well, I'm assuming that by next week you probably won't have anybody hired. She said we had nobody apply. I said, oh, wow.
So
it's a shortage of lifeguards.
If they have them, if they don't.
I'm going to cancel the trip if they don't. Because we talked to them the other day.
Right.
No, I didn't think I had to.
I wasn't even thinking that would be the cost.
Discussing it, comfortable with, you know, with trained CPR, trained counselors.
Is every kid going on the first field trip on Tuesday?
We don't even know that, I don't think.
I don't even know who's coming.
There's a parent that doesn't know that that's what's happening Tuesday, so people are really, like,
Should we say no the first?
She's like, they'll tell us, right? I'm like, yeah, you'll know.
Is it too early, like, it's Tuesday, and camp begins on Monday, is it too early to have a field trip?
I'm gonna leave that up to the staff, if they feel comfortable making that call.
You get extra adults the first.
I'll go on Tuesday.
I have Tuesday off. I was supposed to get my mom's stuff for her, but that was already taken care of, and I heard that.
I'm pretty sure.
Well, on Monday, we'll have to advise them as they're checking in, you know, we're having a trip tomorrow to Point Lake, are you going to be attending? Perfect, and you also owe us $265, have a great day.
On the other hand, it might be a great way to kick off camp.
Right, oh, yeah.
You know what I mean, so.
I think.
You've been on these trips in the past, how do you feel about, how many kids usually have gone in the past on these trips?
At least half of the camp, both shows for each team of trips. It ends up being a counselor gets in the past, each counselor would get 3 or 4 kids to watch the entire time, and they would just move us back. I think for the field trips that makes more sense, even though with the swimming box I think it could work in theory, but I don't think our numbers are where he thinks they are, so. I think it would be fine.
A couple sixth graders and a couple first graders in a group in the last time.
Are you going to group them already?
Yeah, they'd be.
Maybe that was for adult, having your responsibility, or whatever.
Where do you guys go? I'll be following you right from my room in my car.
In your bus?
In my air conditioned car, I'll be right behind you.
Oh, yeah, so you want me to bring up grouping rather than the box thing?
I'm just thinking if there's two counselors for a group, even if it's 12 kids, half of them want to go in the water, two of them want to go in the water, a counselor has to go with them.
Yeah, we have to trust Andy because he's done this before. We hired him for a reason. They know what they're doing. At this point, we have to let them come to these calls. So they're the ones that are going to be out there. So.
I'll speak with Jess too.
And anyone?
Yeah, definitely you are. And you know what, let's,
if you have to duct tape them on the way home.
I will send Dee, I know she's on vacation, but I will send her a note to say, we are going to Pawtucket on Tuesday. Should we start that if you would like to go? Do we want a list of that? Or be ready to sign up on Monday, first day of camp?
Yeah,
okay.
Absolutely.
Does that sound right?
Do we even need to send out a note about that? The parents are dropping them off.
I could send it, I could do a Facebook little blast.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Why don't we chaperone two little kids, one must go here and
talk to you.
Figure it out. Yeah, well, how will we do this anyway? It's not like, yeah, well, we're going to be just going to get
and the little ones just really like to play in this animal at the time, and then they go in the water and then they come back. But we're saying that they're fans, and then they go in the water and they come back.
Oh, yeah. Sure, let's
see. Oh, yeah,
sure.
I think that's actually
what
we put
there.
So,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. They walked.
Oh, they did?
Yeah. And he's like, oh, my God, I know her.
So, Dan, you're going to put something on the Facebook page. And I can send out something to Tia tomorrow. To send it out email blast.
No. Do you feel comfortable telling everybody in the world where our children are gonna be?
I was just
5 days in advance.
No, I was just gonna say in my email blast, like, Camp Raleigh parents, be prepared to sign up for field trips on Monday.
Should I do it?
private page or an email list.
That's what Dee has, and she's on vacation in Hillside.
No, the Facebook site is only people who have looked up at the Facebook site. So.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Someone has to so go.
Good
point.
What's wrong with this? Am I being overprotective?
Yeah, because all we're saying is, on Monday, please be prepared to sign up for trips. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying when the trips are, where they are.
What are you saying about saying that Tuesday we're heading, but should I not? Should we just say...
Am I just being overprotective? It's okay.
I think if we stick to the Facebook, that's just people who have...
It's fine.
And so, no email blasts right now, stick to the Facebook, and then Monday, as people check in, so you might want to make sure that you have an email sign up on Monday.
And what numbers do you want people to sign up
for? Oh, we can have
sign
up.
True.
I mean, there's no reason why they can't sign up on the first date for all of them if they want to. Here's my $70.
So, $70 for what?
It's $5 for the bus. I was pretending I had three kids or whatever.
So, Jody's saying maybe. Since Dee has all the parent information, let her send out an email over the weekend when she gets back.
On Facebook,
to say, can you send something out when you get back? So, I'm going to move down to the next thing on the agenda, which was t-shirts. They're all in. They're all sorted by who's getting what. Community shirts are going out. They're starting to be delivered. Had about half of them picked up between yesterday and tonight. Half the t-shirts, red community shirts, have been picked up. I sent out an email saying I'll be at Town Hall tomorrow during my open hours to pick up. I'm going to stay outside.
Thank you. They are still wondering what
the So I will be outside picking up t-shirts. I need...
For town folks.
I have to call one or two people. We've received an additional couple of orders. And one that came in today from the police department, one of the officers ordered something. I need from Brittany and Andy to find out when a good time to drop off counselor t-shirts are. I have not separated them completely.
Okay,
Let them fly.
We're ready.
So. They can get those shirts. We're leaving them with our children.
I know.
They're saving the pile. But it's hard.
Because
I'm out of town tomorrow.
Yeah.
I can move stuff right out of the door.
No, I'm fine. I'm just thinking, like, I know I've emailed Kelly about it, but, like, there are exactly enough shirts in two sizes, and then there's extras in the other sizes. And I want them to, you guys who have ordered the like mediums and larges, to actually see what they are and decide if you want extras or whatever, or if you want to switch sizes.
And yeah, I give it to them.
And I didn't have
an figure it out.
Yeah, and yeah. I didn't have all the counselors. So.
So my daughter will kill me for asking this, but
medium.
Altering the shirts in any way? Are we okay with that? Okay, you need to make sure that you have...
It's going to be addressed
on
Thursday.
Cool.
Meaning not cut off
sleeves.
Right, you can't cut them up.
You
can roll them up.
Yeah, I'm sure you
can
roll them up.
You just can't cut them off. You want to look neat.
I like them.
Presentable. And then maybe next year you can go with a lighter color for them.
What? I know, you're
saying
I want, well,
hook somebody up.
Come on.
And set up, now I, there was a question forwarded to me about setup, so I, are we making that decision, or are you guys making that decision?
He asked you, so I wasn't sure, what time we wanted to do.
And then my thing was like, oh, am I making that decision?
Sunday.
It's happening on Sunday.
Louise's first game will be at 8 on Sunday, and she'll be done by 10, so I will be there in February.
And I can always be there until
like 11. How much time are we thinking this is going to be?
That was the question I had. What are we calling set up? Are we moving all of the donated goods into the shed to call it cookie stuff out of the shed?
I think most of that stuff is gone.
Okay. So
all the garbage, I believe, is gone.
Okay. So I'd just be moving all of the.
I have our
stuff.
Volleyball net, so I think that should be set up. Can we just, can we leave the volleyball net on overnight?
Doesn't somebody mow it? They do mow, but not all the time.
If you mean Taylor would be over there after hours, you know.
I think that's great, honestly. I mean, if people in the community want to use it,
well, then she can ask.
Why not?
Isn't Kate leaving town? Didn't they send some letter that said they were going out to Oregon or something?
They're
like
yeah, they're already gone. It's okay.
We can make them all around the net. That'll be
fine. So Sunday, what time do you want
to
do that? What did Jordan say about when she's available? Your daughter's playing, right?
Anytime after 10,
yeah.
She said. It's a double
do it noon?
Single.
Do
it.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah.
I'm a badminton net too. The volleyball net looks very complicated, so I'll let you guys figure that one out.
So, noon?
Sure.
Yeah, sounds good.
A couple hours maybe.
So, what time are we going?
I will be there.
Noon time, Sunday.
I will not be there.
Sorry, we'll have, you know.
All the staff will be there, right? I'll be there. I can hang out.
It was in the email last year. You tell them I'm there. I'm supposed to laugh today.
Okay, so set up is noon.
Sean, is there any way for me to get? I know you sent me that email about the new stuff that came in, the sports stuff. The stuff that's upstairs.
Yeah, we're going to have to get that.
When would be a good time for me to get that stuff?
Sunday 11 o'clock.
You know,
I'm laughing
because
you just got the butterfingers from the softball game.
Yeah, I can just bring it over on Sunday, or
okay.
If you're going to be there, we can, I'll bring over what I can on my way there,
right,
and then we'll make another trip.
Yeah, okay.
I think there's two big boxes or three. All right, forget. All
right. And that's including the upstairs, the
yep.
Log
and everybody
stuff.
Knows.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
What about like art supplies and things like that?
Well, let's back up for a minute.
Hold on, there's a checklist going on.
I have
a schedule.
T-shirts from counselors. They get to keep them, or do they have to give them back in with the idea? I'm just asking.
No.
If you try to give those out next year,
save them. There'll be some good fit stain marks in those.
What?
I think this was yours last year. There you go.
No, thank you.
What size were you last year?
So, moving on to sponsors and donations. I went out and pounded pavement last week and offers from pizza places and so forth. So we already knew about the $50 gift cards from Rogers, or from Wheatsy's Pizzas. Rogers has given a donation of $25 worth of pizza.
Rogers?
Pizza.
Okay.
And Dover.
So we have a $25 donation from there. Old Rail Pizza of Somersworth has agreed to give us a buy one, get one free offer. So every pizza we buy, they will match, cheese, pepperoni, whatever. Super Pizza out of Dover has 18-inch pizzas, which are extra large, and they will give us each 18-inch pizza for $8 each. And they suggested since, that's their school rate, and since they are so large, they suggested on the days that we get their pizza, we charge $2 a slice, and we make back our money, or we double our money, because we get $16 versus $8.
We already posted the amount, you can't do that, because we've already stated.
Slice in half.
Yeah.
That big.
Just make it,
yeah.
Just make it
16
slices.
add pizza cutter to our list of needed items.
$1.
Did you?
I think.
Scissors. Yeah. Same scissors she cut the
kids' hair. Papa J's has offered us $55 for 8 pizzas, which includes delivery and tax to the school. And that breaks out to be under $7. So I would suggest that maybe Brittany and Andy look at these 5 places to be our first pizza places, and then we can talk about that later, other places, because I have a couple more flyers out there to places that we know have donated to other agencies in the past. So my other question, though, is that I went to Pizza Hut, and they cannot do anything because they were just bought out by another corporation. But we have a bus July 5th, which we're going to the pool, and Pizza Hut at lunchtime offers $5 a head for a lunch buffet. Do we want to do that, or is that
no,
too much?
Right.
No,
no.
That's
not good.
Bring
them pizza.
For a buffet?
For lunch.
For a buffet.
So I just figured I'd ask.
So, yes, to see.
Thank you for checking.
So the that and then I also emailed you guys. I think that Junados has given us an opportunity to go in there and spend $25 in their cigarette in Dover.
Andy said that it would be smart to use that mostly for water because the kids are going to fly through water faster than the snacks.
Yep. And I was thinking along the same lines.
Okay.
So, Deb Nichols, one of the teachers at the school, is working with somebody who gave us a donation financially, but the volunteer in her classroom emailed me and said she is willing to give us her colored pencils and markers, whatever she has left over at the end of the year, and would like to know if we would like it.
Absolutely.
I'm in the school tomorrow. I can,
is the one that emailed me.
I didn't know that was there.
So, that is where we stand right now with donations and sponsorships and all other money. Oh, we also received an anonymous donation of a $25 gift card to Market Basket, 3 watering cans, 10 bamboo sticks, 12 pairs of gloves, 6 little shovels, 12 pruning scissors, 6 hand rakes, cucumbers, cherry tomatoes, green peppers, watermelons, peppers, zucchinis, an Easy Up, a Nerf dodgeball, bocce, 7 packages of 8 cheese and crackers or peanut butter and jelly crackers, 4 packages of 6 granola bars, and 2 packages of 14 cheeses.
Was this 1%?
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
And
a partridge in a pear
tree. We were all thinking that.
Yeah, we were.
This person must have been watching our videos because they've also donated a laundry basket along with pet food, treats, and toys to give to the Humane Society, and wants to know if we can give a sign to allow campers to donate to the Humane Society on the first Wednesday. The Humane Society is coming the first week, and we want to give them something to thank them. So that was all the ones.
Wow, that was amazing.
I think it was to put everything in.
Was the laundry restroom?
Put all the donations in.
Like,
for pet food, or grooming, or toys for animals, to go to the Humane Society. So, that is done. So, yes.
That's pretty awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you, yes, wherever you are.
Thank you.
So that was sponsorship donations, camp activities. Kathy and I met earlier today. One of the donors got back to us in the last couple weeks, or got back to Kelly, and she forwarded it to us, that they gave us a $250 donation and wanted to see some sort of wild animal people come in, either Squam Lakes or Seafield Science Center, or Center for Wildlife out of Cape Medic.
What about that thing for they're doing in Dover, that email was just sent
yes,
to us?
Yes, and I have
that's
that.
Free, and we got to get there.
Yeah, so there's this, we need a bus.
Wasn't that on a Wednesday?
It was on a Thursday.
Yeah, it is first come, first serve, too. Is that the one each one?
Yeah. Do we want to book a time for the kids? Or
can they take 70-something people? Actually, when you count the counselors, it's 80.
It was sent to campers.
I got it in an email.
Yeah, it came to all of us in an email.
I mean, they're sending it to the recreation department.
It says book your slot early.
We went here last summer. We went to this last summer.
And we liked it. Was it cool?
Yeah, we liked it.
So that's on a Wednesday, though?
Thursday.
And when do we do our trips? Tuesdays? So we could potentially do an extra trip that week, and it's covered by that person.
And what day is on?
A Thursday.
July 21. Oh, like it might be one of the baby days.
One of the what?
The baby days. We're still going to work around the baby, too.
Baby.
I still don't know when that is. But it's supposed to be done by the 20th.
What were you saying, though, Lester? You were saying so we could use that donation as bus money?
Because that's going to be an extra bus.
Right.
Cover that bus.
It'd take us there. How long is the slots? Do you know?
The Woodman Museum.
I don't know. I didn't email them back. It's
like,
we should get on that quick though. If it's something that we're thinking about.
So.
It's probably at the same time, right?
It's
10 to 3.
You have to book it, and they fill up. You have to pick your slot.
So we could go there and then go to Pizza Hut.
We have all the kids.
Dapper guys eat your lunch on the front lawn or something like that, right?
And when I met with Kathy earlier, she has already booked the police department for 1 o'clock that day to come in and talk.
On the 20th?
On the 20th. The police department will be coming in to talk to the kids on Thursday, July 20th.
So then we would want to maybe get the earlier slot on this, however long these slots are.
How long is it? Do you remember from last year?
We were there for at least 2 hours.
So
we got the 10 a.m. slot.
10 to 12.
10 to 12, but if they're coming in the morning, what time?
Oh, they come at 1
o'clock. 1.
10
to 12. We have lunch time, too, for them, the kids, right?
We ate there.
Okay.
And then they could bus back for, do you want me to call? I'll do that.
Even if you did it from 10 to 12, at least you're within a lunch time frame.
So we can look into that. However, Kathy and I, we ruled out Seco Science Center because they only take 30 participants at a time. We'd have to do 2 groups, and that would be $300 plus mileage.
Plus the kids have probably already been there, some of their
groups. So wildlife encounters, they could come to us for $195 and do everybody, and they would bring one wildlife interpreter and 6 interactive animals. However,
is that for a big group?
It doesn't matter the size. What do I want to say? Center for Wildlife is $170 to come in for 50 to 100 kids to book a program for them. And Squam Lakes has a really good program this year. I'm getting a head note. They would come to us.
You missed that one, didn't you?
And it's $250 for the town nonprofit rate.
Ah, you missed that one, didn't you?
And
you got $250 covered.
Yeah, you got $250 exactly.
But if you were budget cautious, you could end up with a wash.
Well, if you do the $175 and also the bus, is $75, right?
I would have to look way back in our notes. It's more than that. You have to order the bus for it's a 4-hour limited time. So
I swore it was $75 or $95, depending on the size of the bus.
That was like passenger.
I think that's people.
Yeah, $75 or $95 people to fit like the size of the bus.
I was thinking money too.
I'd have to check.
I thought
it was people. We have $250 to use for some sort of wildlife.
Yeah, right. And so the UNH thing means we go there, so we have to pay for a bus when we go to the Woodland Institute over.
But it's free. So the $250 goes
we're
toward
covered
our bus.
Yes.
So it would be free for everybody to go.
And if,
or you could have something come to us, which would be like the Center for Wildlife, which would bring in. And you'd still have $75 left over.
You don't have to worry about buses.
And they would come to us. And I've already given the date of August 3rd, which they're fine with.
For what?
Center for Wildlife.
No.
Coming in from Cape Kennedy.
What are they
bringing?
What?
They would.
I went to a thing.
They have a bunch of programs, and we could pick which program we wanted. I put down seasonal wildlife adaption, so how animals adapt to the different seasons, as one, as our top choice right now. What I found interesting about Squam Lakes is that when they come to us, they have a new program that coordinates with the summer reading program, which is national, Build a Better World, and so their Build a Better World is bringing in animals that build their own homes, like birds and stuff, and talking about how the birds build their houses. And that would tie into the summer reading program, and the kids are coming here on Wednesdays anyway. So, what is your guys' preference?
Are we picking, or are we letting Brittany and Andrew pick?
$250. You decide.
You have $250, what would you like to do with it?
We need to work for this.
Yes. Do you take it easy?
I think that we have utilizing the game of our contract, right? Already from the school. And with all of the
are you looking for like change? So you're looking to
leave
the building?
Yeah, I think having everything come to the school, the kids are not going to find it as exciting
anymore.
Yeah,
I think they'll start more.
And it won't be fun. I think they come on any of these, they love this kind of stuff, but the excitement factor, I'm not sure.
Well, you said you went to the UNH thing, right?
Right.
So
they loved it.
They did?
Yeah, they loved it.
I see we go for that.
Yeah,
that's my vote. Brittany, what about the Milton thing?
Yeah, I loved it.
Well,
like,
the Milton counter is
going
to be there.
It's on Wednesday.
So I think the first.
I love the flyer thing.
Yeah, every Wednesday they're doing something for kids. They got awards pictures of other people's kids. So
that's mine.
And it's free, but of course the teacher's there and you stay. And you have to get there.
Oh,
that's another boss.
Well,
that's $250. It almost even covered the kids to get in. And also, it's like, it's very wildlife.
Well, that's
Yeah.
say, just bring it.
We are like, just 5 days we've got.
And that's, they would come in and the price is circled correctly. And the date is circled down below.
Yeah.
So, the wildlife encounters is July 5th.
And then there was another one, right?
The Squam Lake Central Center?
But.
The Tri-Kinetic.
Never mind, I won't even write that one.
Is that the wave squash?
Wave squash.
So, it's down to the UNH thing at Woodman Institute or the,
And then I do have the.
Center for Wildlife that they're trying to get into. I'm gonna backtrack, go back to scholarships and donations, because I didn't think Jody was gonna be here, but we had a question. Is that we gave out, two people applied for financial aid and they were in the bracket, they got it. And that's all the scholarship money we have. And we were actually short. We were actually short half of one. So we have made up some of it in t-shirt sales from the campers. We've brought in $112 so far in extra camper shirts. And that would put us $8 off of the tuition of $240.
We had a donation today.
Okay.
That was Suzanne.
Did it come in?
Yeah.
I don't want to say anything unless it came in.
Yeah.
It came in? Okay. Mr. Electric had gone out to Suzanne's house to do some work at her house. And instead of invoicing her, he said just pay it forward to, to the town any way you see fit, and so you donate the $100 to the right committee.
Okay, so I'm adding to my donations the $250 for the wildlife and
no. You already have that $250 in there.
That $250 is already in there.
Yeah.
It was the donor came forward and said I would like to see this.
It was from Victoria. It was a Vicky.
Okay, that's fine.
Yes.
So, okay, so then I'm just adding $100.
Yes, that came today. I did see the check.
Did you see that? Okay.
Yeah.
So thank you, Mr. Electric, and thank you, Suzanne.
Thank you.
So then we are just shy of $20, which we should be able to make up for in some of our other funds, like camper shirts that we.
Well, I paid the registration.
So other camp activities, I did get hold of the Wentworth House as it was suggested to me way back when, and the Wentworth House Arch is willing to do three groups. They want to break it down into grades 1 through 3, 4, 5, and 6 through 8, and they have separate dates. They're hoping that you can do a 1 or 2 hour, you can walk over there because it's right here in town. Mm-hmm. They have not given me a price right now. They want to know if the dates in here will work with the program. And they will do colonial games with each of the groups, and they would have 2 or 3 other age-appropriate activities cycled there, and the kids could just cycle through. And if you're there for 2 hours, it would be 40 minutes per activity. So here are the dates, July 24th, July 31st, and August 3rd. And then they suggested things like butter making and stenciling on cloth and stitching and weaving and stuff like that, depending on the kid's age range. And they want to know if it's okay with us, if those dates are good with us, what they will give us a price, but they need to talk to their volunteers.
But that's 3 buses.
No, that's the one house they could walk.
Oh, right. You know that.
So walking.
Do you know where the train tracks are in Hall's automotive? You know where the post office is?
Yes.
It's a walking post office.
Okay. It's near the dump.
Transfer station.
It's really close to where we are right now.
Okay.
Even closer to the school.
Okay, great.
the kids have walked there before, so it wouldn't be that far of a walk.
Okay.
Most.
Okay, great.
I think he probably, do we have to do all three age groups? Because I'm thinking you might get more participation with the younger versus
right.
the older kids.
Yeah.
I've probably gone there a few times.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking the oldest group, you may get limited participation on that.
Oh. Sorry, I started writing on it.
That's
okay.
Just
so I think maybe Andy and Brittany need to look at it and decide if it's something feasible and let me know as soon as possible so I can get back to them. And we can find a price, because if it's not actually feasible, we may not be able to do it.
I'm meeting with you tomorrow, so I will have that for you tomorrow.
Celia, so they said they would have to charge us for that?
The last paragraph on here from them
this
says...
This is the Rollinsford Summer Recreation Program.
We still need some tentative dates to work in... to work within order to recruit some volunteers. So it would be helpful if we could start there. I have not yet given any thoughts to price, but we'll keep it within reason.
Nothing.
They are a non-profit here in town.
They are non-profit in town.
So I am not sure. I could suggest to them that instead of, since if we go with this, that maybe we make a donation to their nonprofit instead of a set fee.
You gotta keep in mind that, I mean, I'm sure Andy has ideas about, you know, which girl type sports.
Yeah, we talked about doing some Olympics and.
Yeah, so I mean, we don't want to like totally pack in so much where. Well, I mean, a lot of these kids are going to summer rec to play in the fields with their friends. You know
yeah.
what I mean? So we don't want to just, we don't want to overload these guys with all of these activities.
Give them a pig
to
live in summer rec. They can do whatever
I want. Right. A lot of it is the free, just like play with their friends.
Yeah,
you know,
the lack of
friends. Yeah.
Which
it's like you
don't
want to
chaos.
Be structured.
And
to find the balance.
Yeah. I hate to burst the bubble of the older kids not liking it, because I know at least one of the older kids volunteers there and loves it. She may just be a abnormal kid, but she does volunteer there, so she may be all set to go over there and bring out other kids her age.
Here's what I would suggest to Andy about that. Maybe if there are the one or two older, like the fewer, the smaller amount of older kids, just go with another group, because our 1 through 3 is 34, so if even 10 kids from the 6th through 8 want to go, they can just go with the 4 or 5s. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. To make the groups even. So, one, put the kibosh on it. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that none of them are going to want to go.
Yeah.
So, we could leave that possibility open for them.
My cake decorating lady said she can come in on Monday. Those are her days off, so if you want to let Kathy, I know that.
I thought she was coming back.
She said she would probably take, she would need probably an hour. And that she would bring in all the little cakes, or as many.
She's going to bring in 80 little cakes?
That's what she said. Let me know how many people are signing up for it. And
tell her 81 of them.
Did
she give you particular Monday so I can get a sign-up sheet ready?
No, so that's what, I just wanted to let you guys know that she's available for a Monday, so if you want to look over the schedule and, like, tell me
mm-hmm.
what a good Monday would be and what time you would rather have her.
I'm going to write down Kate Lady, is that okay?
Sure.
Okay.
Kate Lady.
Like, that's funny.
So I think that's it for camp activities. Community service, the fire department is meeting tomorrow night from what I understand, so we should be able to give you a date on Thursday for when they're coming to do an explorers program for the older kids.
anything you need to report to us about the school? Because I have units on there.
School?
Yeah, like, and RGS connection, anything that we need to know about the school?
I put everything in that email. I haven't talked to Kate since, because it didn't sound like I had any questions for her from that email. Yeah, Andy and I have keys.
Joe, no, that's good. Has there been discussion about this waiver thing?
Insurance thing?
Yep, Caroline was working on it today. She just wants the Primex paperwork that says, right?
Yes.
The transfer from Primex.
Yeah, sorry.
That's not a big deal.
And will
No, she was doing that today. We just got bogged down this week with emergency.
Because won't they also need something for like Friday, because they're going to be in the school Friday, 4 to 8, and Sunday for setup time?
No, it's a blanket.
Oh, it is?
It's on you now, kind of thing.
Okay.
So, just like basketball.
Okay.
It's basketball season, it's on you.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's on you.
Except for it isn't on us.
It is on the town. When if something happens in basketball, the town.
Yeah, but some employees still have to be there for the basketball.
The town's policy takes over if someone gets hurt or something like that. So, is that what you mean?
No, but it's okay. I don't want to.
You don't want to be your
privilege, so we'll just move
yeah,
on.
Yeah, sure.
So, Brittany, but if I can recall, so it's the faculty room, we have access to everything in the faculty
yes,
room.
Yes, okay, so we have the teacher's room, the gym, and the stage, which is what I figured we were going to get.
I'm sorry, which rooms?
The teacher's room, stage, and the gym.
So they're not giving up the kindergarten room again?
No classroom?
With the bathroom?
Classroom.
No, no classroom at all.
What? We're all moving around.
She told me that it was the classroom.
She told me stage. Yeah.
Are they going to clean up all the stuff on you?
Yes, there's going to be nothing
so
on the stage.
It's like a clutter.
Are you guys going to be okay with that?
I think it's going to be fine.
Well,
last year they didn't have the gym because they were doing the floors, right?
Oh,
right.
Yeah.
So that's why there was an issue last year.
This is better. We have more space this way.
Okay.
And if it rains, at least they have somewhere to go.
Yep, and it was in
not
the email, but she's getting me a screen and projector that I will have easy access to for rainy days. So that's taken care of.
Great. Kathy did mention that the library is also available for the kids to come down and do summer reading activities here.
Yeah.
Or to come down and check out books, which it's on the schedule for every Wednesday, but if there's like a rainy day, they also have that room off of there that's open.
I talked to Sarah about
this. Well, they have to get here on a rainy day,
and
that would be
why. Max should be 16, two groups of 8. That should be the max.
How much?
16 kids at a time in this place. I mean, I asked her, she wasn't all. Adamant about it, but she said, well, 20 it's a little crazy. Like when a class from RGS comes
right.
down, 20 is it's a lot.
Yeah.
So you have
it's usually pretty quiet in here.
Right.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
cool.
Yeah.
You know, and it could just be kids who just, many kids are not going to want anything to do with it. But
mm-hmm.
there might be kids who've done a really hot day, might want to come down here, and the ACs will be in and sit and read a book for a while or hang out there. And just a good option.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you have to do.
The other thing is that the summer reading program starts next week, so the kids can come down and they can sign up
yeah.
here,
mm-hmm.
and they can check.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and they can check books in and out, and if mm-hmm. they sign up here, it helps the library too because the more kids they get signed up for summer reading, the more money they can get from the state for participation.
So we can sign all 74.
Well, they'll just keep sending emails because we have to pay for books. They never return.
Yeah.
That's how library works.
Oh.
So, other thing for you, Brittany, is that I had a discussion with Doodlebugs, and I've been going back and forth with our sponsor, or this is basically for everybody, but Doodlebugs needs tables and chairs on July 17th. For their glass project.
Okay.
And
are they going to be able to use the stage or do they need a bigger space, do you know?
I think that may be all right.
but she said tables definitely, and then access to water is highly recommended.
Like the bathroom is okay, or do they
need like a sink? Because like when, in case somebody like gets a prick or something, she rubs their hands or whatever. She said she's gonna bring in all pre-cut stuff, I think, or she's gonna bring in all non-jacket stuff.
What day is it?
July 17th.
You will be there. She's marking her. Go to
The sponsor wants us to take pictures. The grant grantor wants us to take pictures, which brings me to a question of, are we relying on Andy and Brittany and so forth to take pictures on their own devices? Do we have a camera that we can use?
Does your camera have film?
Yes.
Okay, we're good.
Yeah, I'm good to use my phone. I'm sure Andy is too, if that's okay with you guys.
Okay, I'm going to call Lester. Sorry, Jim.
did we sign? We have permission to take pictures of everybody in the packet?
Okay. I believe so.
Thank you. I don't remember what I signed. It's been so long.
Or did you not read it? That's pulling a Lester.
My story.
I did read it. I was the one that noticed
that we didn't have the consent. She's going to start it down. And she's going to run the groups consecutively until they're done.
In there.
Groups of 24.
Thank you.
How long is the show?
Like 4.5 hours to 40 minutes.
I don't know if they're on licenses then.
I saw that movie one. I don't know if we do have that.
That was good.
Sunscreen, movies, and permission to walk off site.
Dan, do you have something, some generic form from school? I know there's one that the grade schools use. It might be on their website.
It is, it's in the parent, it's in your
handbook
thing on the book,
yeah? Yeah, it's in that little arrow calendar.
I don't get that.
I get two.
I do too.
I get four.
But when I get to it,
can someone
get rid of one? I'll look at one.
Just redo
it. It basically just states that you can video, photograph, something, whatever. Because you know how they load them up to the school website?
I guess a few schools.
You have those forms out on the bird.
On Monday, yeah.
When you sign up for a trip, you also have to allow your child to be photoed.
My experience is it might be three kids who the parents don't want. We usually get the list at St. Thomas out of 500 kids. It might be four or five kids.
You've got to remember which kids.
Exactly. It's only a few.
It might be easier to, if you don't want your child photographed,
fill this out.
But you need written permission to be able to. Yeah. You need permission from them because they might. Oh, I didn't see that. I don't.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
All right.
Yep. You have that ready for Sunday.
Make it on top of that,
right? You got an assignment.
Can I have a piece of paper?
There you go.
Yep.
Come home with me. So if we're taking pictures, where are we storing
them? There we go.
Facebook?
Do you want it on the Facebook page or do you want it on the regular Facebook page? Like now that the season has started, do we close the page?
I think on the discussion before that once everybody is registered, we close the page.
Right, and now it's a closed page that you have to be invited to, but then you gotta unlike the people that have liked it that don't have kids enough.
What's wrong with keeping it public if they've signed a waiver and what's the drawback?
Do you have to state where it's going to be loaded? Because I think it's stated in the RGS thing that it would be uploaded to the website or the school classroom newsletters, stuff like that. I think it was specific, if I remember right.
No, the Dover one.
It's been several months.
It could be here. It could be there. It could be in the newsletter.
I know for a fact she has it.
Yeah.
Because it came home it comes home every year, right in the beginning of the year, in that big gigantic packet. You get writer's cramp.
Never seen it.
So, is it,
what, from me?
Are we going to store the photos on Facebook, or is that a question?
Who wants the pictures?
REF wants them, the funding source for Doodlebugs. But I think it's also good, like, if we just have people taking pictures throughout the summer, show what our program's like, and then at the end of the summer, we can have them for a brochure or for publication next year.
You can find the town website under summer rec. You can't.
Well, okay. Well, you could, but you could. The idea of the pictures is, I don't care where we put them, it's just a fact of rights and security.
I vote for them.
So, I enjoy getting the pictures during the day when the counselors snap them and I can see Zach jumping over the sprinkler or whatever is doing, being in the monitor or whatever. So, I enjoy
it. I can do that
it.
For you.
Right. So.
I do too. I get the notification from the class.
Right. But you know, that camp that they were at last year was a closed group. That's my only.
Oh, and how did they?
And ours isn't a closed group. So that was my only question. So.
We could sit there, could we?
I was thinking the same thing.
So, and it's up, and it's up to you guys. My kids are on Facebook anyway because I posted for them.
But then you're worried about the people that are already on the group.
Let's just make it a closed group.
Would come with.
Right, the people that are already on the group that don't have children in it, we have to unlike them. So.
I mean, next year.
I mean, we could just make a separate closed one just for pictures and invite the parents for that.
And the sponsors?
Yeah.
Yeah, you go in and invite them.
Yeah.
Right, and just leave that other one kind of just in
there. Yeah, we could just have us.
Make it a 2017 camp
ride. Addendum to the Facebook page, just a different offshoot. Picture offshoot. Yeah, it's probably the easiest way to handle it.
Yeah, like summer camp has 123 members this year from the other camp. So, and you would get pictures every day. And they're adorable, I love them.
And if you loaded them up to Facebook, or if the counselors had loaded them to Facebook, post them there, then they can delete them from their phones and don't have to use their memory.
So I'm making a separate
closed
Facebook for your pictures?
Yeah.
So I'll just do that.
I would rather do that.
Camp rally photo.
Okay. And then you can just tell the parents what they did.
Usually it's all
right.
Let me try to sleep.
And can you address that with the counselors during training?
Yes.
I'm sure you can probably make this all happen more quicker than we could do.
We weren't going to let them have their phones.
Perfect.
Is that okay? So it would just be Andy and I taking pictures? So not even bring it up to the counselors?
So how are you not going to let them have their phone?
They're
going
to have
walkie copies.
Yes.
Right. That's, okay, but where are their phones going to be?
They're going to go in their bag. Their bags are going to go in the teacher's room. The teacher's room, no kids are allowed, and they know that from school. And then they have like 2-3 minutes, 5 minutes during lunch to go check their phones, answer messages, and then put it back in the bag.
Because they're eating lunch with kids.
Yes.
Technically, by rule, as soon as somebody is on a playground with a child and we do this, am I correct on this rule?
Mm-hmm.
That the number of ratio dwindles. Like I actually had a patient get fired for doing that. I guess at a preschool.
It's just, it's just bad news. They can't be on the phones when they're watching kids.
And I know that
a lot of counselors are in
the staff. I've known a staff person in a school who looked down at their phone, and when they looked back up, the child they were supposed to be watching was along the banks of the Piscataquis River in Portsmouth.
Details.
Mm-hmm. We're going to box them in. Don't worry about it.
Box
diamond. Sorry, thank you. My idea. We're going to call it a lesson.
And then you can send out notifications of what you're doing that week.
Because I was going to ask how I was supposed to print things, but I'll have that.
Yes.
usually at least, moms usually get that.
Is there a way to link it up with the Facebook page we already have? Can we build it off of that one, or?
I think you have to create a new one.
Yeah, you just have to create a whole new one.
Right, as a closed group or a group.
D could give you the, like, the JPEGs or whatever to make it look.
Similar.
You know, similar to it.
I mean, I can go on and say those can do that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's just a photo.
Yeah.
Yeah, or yeah, whatever, I don't know.
How are you inviting, how do you know who to invite?
No. Because it got sent to my Yahoo and registration email, I'll probably get on.
And send them an email.
Okay, because I have a parent.
Or you just have that little thing, like this.
When you're checking in your kid, here's our Facebook page if you wanna see the pictures of your kid today.
Yeah, but how do we know that Dan has a kid there, doesn't have a kid there, if he goes to?
You won't be able to get in.
Right. He'll have.
He has to be accepted into the group.
Right.
Right.
So is that.
They're gonna have access.
So then every person that wants access, she needs to go.
Yep.
No, don't see that name.
Yep.
And then what happens when it's.
She knows half the parents anyway.
Yeah.
Right.
So Doodlebugs needs to know if we can send them the REF will pay for $600. Right now we're up to 75 kids. So that leaves 15 kids unpaid for, which would be $150. She wants to know if she can get that money in advance so she can order the glass.
Does she have the $600 on her?
No, they will not give her the $600 until after the program, after they've received her write-up and the pictures.
Oh.
And they get an accurate head count of how many kids participated.
So she wants how much from us?
$150 to get the glass.
Well, let's give her $150.
From what?
According to my records, we have 3 count kids that are paid, so we have money.
Meeting, we were counting roughly $1,500 in activities fees, which didn't include the REF money. So,
how much?
$1,500.
Okay.
What? But we were counting, what was it, $300 or $350 to go towards the pay per fund. And then we had talked about the motorcycle guy being 500 or the bike guy being 500, and we decided to hold off until we got supplies taken care of, like art supplies. So,
kind of a list of stuff.
And so if we can get $150, that'd bring us up to 500, and then that would leave us like $1,000 for other activities and supplies.
Can we talk about like tie-dye?
Yeah,
that's the first week.
Are you guys getting the tie-dye stuff?
Yeah,
I thought I remember hearing stuff.
Kathy's first really.
Dee said she would be sending an email out to remind parents of that. Does anybody need to relay any information to Dee right now?
Yeah, Lester threw a fit because people are not notifying him.
Well, she said the emails I've sent since being here are not going out because of the Wi-Fi. So she has to go up to some so she said she would do that, resending the emails to me and Brittany and Andy, all the paperwork that we would need. That's what she said, is sending out tomorrow. Like, it should be to all of us by tomorrow. By noon, latest noon. So then I said my list for you is a reminder to email parents about the first field trip on Tuesday and the $5 bus fee. So she wanted to know, and else she said the white t-shirt for the first craft, and anything else we need to, I'll tell her.
They're fine.
So every field trip is $5?
Yeah.
And
every
the
Tuesday.
Pool as well?
No.
No, not the pool,
just
Tuesday.
Yeah.
Just Tuesday.
Yeah.
No, Kelly loves swimming, so that's free, but.
Right.
She bought off to that and she won. Next year I get my tux, but.
Yeah, again, next year you get a half hour early.
The next year the deadline's 15:12.
Oh, you know what, I actually have a thought, which I approached, I'd have to clear it with the pool director, but one of the kids on our swim team is a Marshwood High guy, who asked about, he's not old enough to be one of our counselors, so he's asked about community service. He swims for Seacoast, so I had a thought that if we could offer his services at the Jenny Thompson Pool to give free swimming lessons to some of our kids who are going to Jenny Thompson Pool, he could get community service hours for that. So he could.
So then Brittany or Andy would have to sign off on that, right, for the school?
Yeah, I would assume so.
Do they have space for him to do that?
I would have to clear with the pool director, but I was just wondering if we all think that would be a, I mean, he could be in the water for 2 hours. You know, he could run groups of five for every half hour or something. We had that many kids who were interested.
I just don't know if they'd be okay with it.
Right, I don't know either, but.
I think that'd be the first hurdle to overcome.
Right. So I'll have to talk to the pool director, but see what he has to say. He might do it, he might be okay with it because it's community service stuff.
Ask her, ask Dee, you were just saying any other business for her.
Yeah.
What, if she can tell us how much money we have, she has recorded for activities, and whether or not there's enough money to give Doodle Books in advance, like 100.
Well, we were planning on paying him 150 anyway, right?
So what's the difference?
So let's just go ahead and do it.
Yeah, it's in
do
our budget.
Do we need a PO for that?
Probably. Sorry.
Do we need a purchase order for that? To pay Doodle Books a month, 150 by friend?
Yeah. Can I come in and do it next Monday?
Good luck.
Let's hope the dust settles by then.
Is that because of your dream?
And
the drain and the culvert on.
This is completely off subject, but kind of on subject. So that 150, we haven't issued it yet, so I'm not going to put that in here. The only thing that we have cut checks for are the 235 for the field trip and the 1548 for the shirts, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's right.
So, any other business?
They need to fix the paper.
And Dan, mm-hmm. Did you need to talk to him, think about like on-site visits over the summer or anything like that?
I mean, like I said, I'm planning on going to some of the field trips, and I'll be popping in from time to time. And,
how do I join the chaos?
Right. Yeah.
Kelly, the mom or nurse of
yes, I haven't heard back yet. I wanted to make sure I knew which days
okay.
that you guys were going to be doing.
And is it the mom or is it a nurse that
I
they
don't
were?
Know.
Okay.
They were seeing if that educator was available.
Okay.
If not, then it's going to be a parent.
So is this a medically sensitive case that come to camp? Or none of our business?
There is a girl with diabetes that's coming, so
And then, sorry, this is all stuff he gave me to ask you guys. Do we have incident report forms, just in case kids do injure themselves, and then we have a write-up for that?
Call on my highly doubt it.
Okay. That would be smart, and then he'll pick up on me.
He definitely needs one of those.
For police, that's convenient. I mean, what are you looking for?
Ice issue wait, Johnny and ice pack.
Yeah.
Jody, do we have first aid kits from the fire department yet? Is that been
No.
Okay.
Yeah. I have
had it done is keep the kids grouped up, like on the schedule, and then put certain counselors with each age group. And then we think that we head, but they're not going to get the title of head counselor, have a bag full of first aid stuff and their walkie-talkies.
So three different bags?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just three bags.
And they're going to carry that bag around all day?
Yeah. It doesn't need to be huge. You don't need a lot.
Like a mommy bag. Yeah. I call it a mommy bag. I carry a little bit of everything in a bag.
Yeah. It can be a fanny bag.
Yeah.
It'd be great. Stylish. Oh. Fit right in.
You may have Jordan quitting on
Yeah, I was thinking, what year are we pulling back to? Fanny bags?
Fanny bags are great because, you know,
they're very handy.
They're very handy because your hands are free. There are fanny bag first aid things that I saw.
Like I said, yeah, I can see her coming back from day one being like,
yes.
Yes, it's a dark blue shirt. I can't cut it. I have to wear a fanny pack. Fogarty's wants me back. They do. So she'll be like, I'm going back.
She's not allowed to do that.
Oh, because then I'll mess up my ratio.
No, mess up my ratio. There's no quitting, I'm sorry. Like,
and the one
I will gladly take them out of my house at any point in time. I was going to bring everything with me on Sunday. Is that good?
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Okay.
Charge them up.
I was just going to say that they can set them down.
Got it.
You know what
they
I mean?
They asked me because I have all the t-shirts, but maybe it's something that Dee's going to send to you anyway. If she does not, just verify that you guys get the list of kids' names by ages. Because I don't have their ages, I just have the list of names.
Yeah, that it's all on her magical flash drive that we haven't met up to get yet, so.
Tomorrow noon.
Dee?
Got it. I'll get an email tomorrow noon.
And where are all of the actual forms?
She has them.
Okay.
I think she's coming back Saturday.
That sounds right to me.
So, oh, you know what? I'll let her know that we're having set up a new
of every child. Because you have all the information, whether they have a peanut allergy, whether
you should almost get them alphabetical.
That's
by
all,
last name.
I believe she has that all. That's
a
all
binder.
On her master.
No, I mean a paper.
No, like a physical printout of all.
I would put in
They're binder. The person who donated all of that stuff did tell me they are concerned because they did provide peanut butter and jelly crackers that they would be kept separate if there's anybody with a nut allergy.
You do.
Yeah,
you do?
I think we have. And you said Caroline was doing the insurance. And then I kind of asked, but I don't know if I can't, like if there's parents who aren't on Facebook, am I going to have a place to print out things and give them stuff? Because I don't know if I can use the schools.
What about just emailing it? They have an email.
If they don't and you need paper copies, anything you guys need, you can go to town hall and do it.
Is there a photocopier in the teacher's room?
It's not in the teacher's
room. No.
There's the cage, the office, and then the copier room. But I don't think we'll get in there.
Oh, we got a donation of an air hockey table.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I don't know how big it is, but friends of ours were getting rid of it.
At the marquee.
Yeah.
Stage
so I snagged it.
Split half game, half
arts. She wanted to drop it off at my house. I was like,
you
hold on to that until.
Well, the best thing
to camp starts.
Be able to be up there. They need a sink after we figure where that will have to be.
Well, I was trying to figure out how close they need
maybe
it was just in case someone pricks their finger. Well, you have a first.
You know that wide hallway right before the kindergarten? I mean, do we have access to that hallway?
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'll double check with her. Because they're moving all of their classrooms around that hallway again.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're going back to K, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Well, it's a couple, there's a K, there's a couple 1-2s, and then there's a couple 2-3s, and a couple 3-4s, and then 5-6 downstairs. It's a mess right now.
What?
Yeah, they're going back to the, well,
the old school way.
There's no more 4-5-6. So.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I know that.
And they get rid of the 1-2-3-4-5-6 classroom.
Sorry.
They have their teacher put an open class. Should not just sit there and just laugh.
I didn't even ask my kids.
I did. All the training, PowerPoints done for
Just in general.
Over health certifications and whatnot. And then Dave's Friday will be the camera certifications and safety.
Question. Are you guys letting campers have their phones?
So,
was it doing 5-6?
We're thinking the same thing as the counselors, a couple minutes during lunch, and then if they are a part of pre-enrolls, they can have them out to call parents if they're late.
So there's a
Is there going to be like a number to call for? Didn't he say something about emergency? Remember they can't call the school?
Right, yes. She said not calling the school, so the parents are going to have minor mandates.
Are you guys okay with that, or do we have to get a
I think she, and that's what she had suggested, it was, she suggested getting over her own so they wouldn't have our numbers.
Yeah.
I think that would be more safe for us if we had just the, like, the headphone.
And who's going to have that phone?
I would assume Andy.
We didn't talk to anybody there that day.
I was also thinking that nobody would take it home. It would live in a school, because that's where we would need it, and then take it on field trips.
I missed the whole, are the kids able to have their phones?
We were thinking, we were thinking kind of same thing for counselors. They can have it out for a little bit during lunch, and then during pre and post, if they need to call mom or dad or something.
And the reason why we're randomizing there?
Because Kate said that you couldn't call the school, so you have to have an emergency line for a parent or person picking up, right? I would assume any contact.
We're minimizing camper.
Sometimes
that makes
them
less wanting to
do things.
They're going to want to just sit there on their phones.
I mean, my only thought is,
if they have emergencies and like there's family stuff going on, obviously it's not
at all.
Right, they need to go ask.
They just need to tell us.
Track, so,
you can get
them
a
$15
and then you need time.
Right.
For emergencies. Well, that's what we're talking about.
That's
instead of them having a personal. So who's responsible for the camper's phones? When?
It's going to be the same thing. They're going to look in their bags. And each camp is going to have a specific section for their bags.
As long as we're not taking possession of it.
No, we're not taking anything from them.
So my son's phone didn't have a crack before he came to camp, kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and
yeah,
then,
no, we're not
got it.
Touching anybody's stuff.
Okay.
They're going to put it down, they can take that with them.
Cool.
Not doing it.
All right.
So,
here's my question to you.
Yeah.
If you and Andy are going to be taking pictures with your own personal phones,
right,
is there a big deal of giving out your phone number as that emergency contact? Because you and Andy are going to have your phones on you all the time.
Right.
I think that's...
I just don't know if I want midnight texts saying, my kid's screaming because he didn't have fun at camp today.
Or
that's
that 5 a.m. call, my kid's throwing up.
Right.
Well, you're going to get it on ACUS. You're going to get that on...
No, because they're going to arrive at camp. The burner phone stays at camp.
Yeah.
So just like as if they were to call a school, they get a voicemail, they leave a voicemail. Kate comes in the morning and checks the voicemail.
Yeah.
Like a Walmart card phone.
And
portable.
But then do we need two of those?
No,
because
we don't need one. Because if they're there,
don't you buy it by minutes, by month?
I just buy a card phone.
Yeah,
you can buy...
I upgraded my mother's track phone. Ask me why she wants track. She likes track phones, but so I have her little flip phone still. So all we have to do is buy.
in school anyways, and that's just the one line. That's, and they would get a voicemail, or they'd get the secretary saying, they're not here, or like, they're on a field trip. Like, at least on the field trip, we can take that phone with us.
Yeah.
And you might want to put that on the Facebook page once you get the number set up.
I think that should be on a piece of paper when you bring the kids in, that you're getting an emergency phone.
Yeah.
Not everybody's going to be on that Facebook page right away.
Yeah.
Well, on Monday when they sign up.
Here's
the number to call if you have.
Yeah.
And here's the Facebook. Like us, and we might like you back.
Will the school secretary be there?
Not all the time. She,
Was it in your email, Brittany, that you had said that? I read an email that said, Kate said, make sure you have something for a contact number.
Yeah.
Because most parents call the school and there's not something to do with somebody not being there. I remember seeing that. I try to read every email that comes in, to be honest.
I love it. Yeah.
I do too.
You can get a track phone in it for a card for $19.99, $29.99, or up from there. Because I know
the $100 one is going to be long.
Yeah, just
a couple of minutes and stuff like that. So.
But $19.99 is like 60 minutes, and they usually double it to 120. And then like the $29.99 is like 120, and they usually double it to 240.
Any other business?